Good morning and welcome back everyone to Stardew Valley and of course to Chapitel Farm, where we passed out right in front of our bed last night. It is Sam's birthday today. What am I going to get for Sam? Does Sam like spicy things? I think Sam might actually like spicy things. Ah yes, I can hear the spirits whispering something to me. The spirits are mildly perturbed today. Luck will not be on your side. Also, it's raining. Weather report. It's going to be a beautiful sunny day tomorrow. Okay, well, fair enough. Right, well, can we get some more pepper poppers? Well, we can get one. Maybe that'll be something that Sam will enjoy. I do not know. Do we have anything else that we want to drop in there? Not really. Okay, let's go out and find out how much someone... No one robbed me! Oh, that's good. Okay, well, we started with half the energy, but no one came into my house, broke in, kidnapped me, robbed me, and then put me back in my house. That is, you know, something to be happy about, I suppose. Right. Well, let's start off the day by going and checking on all of the animals. Where are you, Snufkin? You're usually outside, even though it's raining. Actually, Akasha, you'll make this a lot faster for me. So let's get to things. Now, other than going and seeing Sam, I'm not going to worry too much about any kind of socializing today. I know I said that yesterday, and then I spent the whole day socializing. But you know it's me, and I've said it today, and I'm probably going to do it again today, and you're just going to get used to this. I can't help being me any more than you can help being you. There we go. I am going to try and just focus on the farm today. I know I say it so many times, and I know I let you down. Okay, well, I'm just pretty happy that all of our lightning rods have just reset. Oh, I don't have my lock pail. Never mind. We'll just say hello to everyone. Hello, pail. Hello, hello, hello. Now, we've got enough money to go get another pig. But, you know, I'm not actually that interested in going to get another pig just yet. It probably is worth it. Ultimately, but I would actually like to do something else. Hello, hello, hello. Hello, hello. This is what I would like to do. Now, I've been advised, don't sell the hops. Turn the hops into something more valuable. Just do that with all hops. However, things like blueberries, they can happily be sold because they've already got a reasonable value as is. Hops, however, do not. Hops are super, super cheap if you just sell them as hops. Whereas they apparently take less time in the keg. I wasn't aware of this. They take only 2 days instead of, I think it's 5 days for anything else. So they do get turned into pale ale much faster, and they go from being worth pennies to being worth about 300 gold or something in that kind of ballpark. So given that, I think we will be converting and instead going for the hops instead in our kegs. Now, we've probably already got enough that'll last us all the way through. Ooh, we've actually got barely any room. But we've probably got enough now that we've got enough blueberries if we were going to be using them in the keg for far longer than December. So we can sell all future blueberries if we want to. If for some reason I really want to use blueberries in something, I can later on. But for now, we're just going to be focusing on all of our hops instead. Now, let's go ahead and place down all of this. There we go. I know I can't fertilize a plant that's already there. Shush you. Doesn't happen. But we can now place all these down. There we go. Glorious in every way. I'm very happy with this. We'll just drop these off so my inventory can open up a little bit. Bump, bump, bump. There we go. Now, let's get all of you lovely things watered. And I do very much appreciate this. So useful. Wild plums. Now, someone has also said that if you use something that... Or rather, sell something that is out of season, it's worth more. That would make sense to me. That would certainly make sense because, you know, they're paying a premium to be able to get this at a time of the year when normally it's not available. There we go, and we'll just do that. But there, the greenhouse is watered. Need to get some stuff in here to help out with that. We've got plenty of blackberries, plums. Oh, I'm pretty happy with that, actually. Very happy. Okay, moving on. Should we check on whether there are any... No, there won't be any more mushrooms, so we're not going to have to worry about that. I need to cut down so many trees, though. Right. Anything? No. I'm going to drop off all of the fruit and stuff that we can process. So, all of these go in here. Yeah, you go in there as well. Now, unfortunately, we can't plant these anymore. Everyone who's given me advice that we could, it doesn't work like that anymore. That has been patched out. You can no longer just randomly plant those things in the greenhouses. Unfortunately. I mean, I say unfortunate, but I'm actually in agreement with it, because people were just basically planting that stuff on the tiling in order to have room. That didn't really seem the way it was intended, to be perfectly honest. But it does suck that I spent all that money on it, and I'm not going to get any benefit from it. Well, you know, you take the good with the bad some days. Right, we are not going to be getting rid of the driftwood. The driftwood will be given to Leah. I know I don't need to, I want to. But for now, it can be stowed. Right, we're going to need to go... do we have the stone? We have this, and I want that. We'll take these as well. I'm going to need a lot of stone. An awful lot of stone. So I'm going to need to make a journey over to Robin's place, because I just flat out need to buy quite a lot of stone at the moment. I do want to go and get a sheep, too. Nope, Akasha, I want to go in there. There we go. I wasn't sure she was going to let me in. Hello, I'm back. There we are. Have you got milk today, girls? No, Evelina does not have milk today. And that means that Bonnie will not have milk either. And Henwen will never have milk. Oh, Blossom has no milk. What's wrong, Blossom? You're right. I think maybe Blossom isn't very happy today. Oh, that's a bit of a shame. All right, well, we're going to swing past Marnie's place. We will... I'll gather all of that later. We've got a little bit of coal over there. I'll also gather that in a bit. Got some peppers down there. We've got a load of things out here that we can deal with. But I want to go and get... actually, I can drop... it doesn't really matter. I'll just carry them with me. It's not a big deal. We want to go and visit the merchant. Hello. I thought the merchant was over here today, but apparently not. Is it not Wednesdays? I thought it was Wednesdays and Sundays. Oh, no, that's right. It's Fridays and Sundays. My bad, my bad. Hang tight there for a moment to catch her. Hi, Jazz. Aunt Marnie won't let me go out after 6 o'clock. It's not fair. Well, she has your best interest at heart. Aavak, you look like you're soaked, you poor thing. Oh, I'm fine. Thank you for the concern, though. Right, I would like to purchase an animal. And it is going to be a sheeple. Adults can be shorn for their wool. Sheep who form a close bond with their owners can grow wool faster. A pair of shears is required to harvest the wool. Lives in a barn. We shall be getting a sheep. And we already have a name for said sheep. This sheep shall be Abigail. There we go. Now, you're going to send little Abigail to her new home right away. Thank you very much, Marnie. No. I haven't got enough money anymore. May I please purchase some shears? Thank you. Goodbye. Right. We need to move pretty sharpish, honestly. I need to put one pepper popper up there. I need to go and find Sam. Now, Sam. You at home at the moment, Sam? Ooh. Okay. What's going on here? Oh, hi, Aavak. I was just about to have a snack. Here, let me get something for you. Okay. What a mess. What was that sound? Well. This is absolutely terrible. What happened? Wow. It's just an egg on the floor. Tell her, Aavak. Sam dropped it on purpose. He thought it would be funny, the scoundrel. No, Sam handed me a snack, then I dropped it. Yeah, that's what happened. Thanks for telling me the truth, Aavak. It's not much of a big deal. I'm sorry about this, Mum. I'll clean it up. Thanks, honey. You're such a good lad. Saved your bacon there, Sam. No, Sam, don't leave. Sorry about what happened earlier. It's okay, Sam. I want to give you... No, Sam. Are you coming out? Catch me up. Sam. You remembered my birthday. Thank you. This is great. You're more than welcome, mate. Right. I don't have too much time to play around, though. We need to make some rapid progress to the north. Ooh, what's on here? I need a jade. It's not too inconvenient. Penny. 600 gold on delivery. Penny will be thankful. I think I've got a jade. I'm fairly certain I do. Maybe I could take it here in the bathhouse. Close on Wednesday. Ah, yes, of course you are. Some terrible weather. That's fine. There's some forest just over there. Now, for those who've been asking what these arrows are, at the highest level that I've gotten to in... if we go to skills here, in foraging, level 10, I've chosen the tracker profession, which gives me basically a forage radar. So at the edge of the screen, if I'm reasonably close to it, then forage will show up. It'll have a little yellow indicator. Ooh. What's going on here? Hello? See, now you knock. Why don't you ever knock when I want to do it? Oh, my lord. Aavak, hi, come in. I love your wallpaper. This looks amazing. I've been working on a new project. Something big. This is just one component. Let me show you a little demonstration. Okay. Just put your hand here. Alright. And I'm going to flip this switch. Oh my god, are you alright? Here, let me apply burn cream. What was this a demonstration? Is this a weapon? In which case, it was very, very functional. Did exactly what it was meant to do. I'm so sorry. It's okay, it doesn't even hurt. You'd better be, this hurts like crazy. I'm not going to be like that, even if it does hurt like crazy. I mean, if I genuinely thought, yeah, my hand is actually, it's changing, it's the wrong color, it's about 8 times too big, or too small, or it's falling off, then I'd be like, it hurt, it's okay, I realize it was a mistake, but please get me to the hospital right away, I'm about to die. But, no, it's okay, I'm fine, you applied a burn cream, I think it was magic cream, because it was green sparkles, that's always an indication of magic cream, but I'm fine, it tickled. Oh, no? Well, that makes me feel a little better then. Thanks. Welcome. Oh, my lord. I kind of ruined the moment, huh? Oh, it's okay. It was kind of you to show me your invention all the same, though I still don't know what it was meant to do. Unless it was actually meant to do that, in which case it doesn't ruin the moment at all. It's exactly what it was meant to do. Hi, Alec. How are you doing today? Well, you know, apart from a burnt hand. Hey, Sebastian. What's the point of going outside? I've already seen it all. Sebastian. Here. I really love this. How did you know? Well, you told me a few times. That's all. Thank you. This is very interesting. You're welcome. I'd like to move past you and talk to your sister. When it rains, I have a good excuse to work on my gadgets all day. Yeah, that's actually pretty funky. Must be kind of boring for you, though. Nah, I got loads of things to do. You know what? Roll your space laser. Is that... Oh, wow, Aavak, this is spectacular. You're welcome. Wow, wait a second. This isn't going to be, like, a habit-forming thing, I hope. Shock me terribly by, you know, come test out my invention. And then I give you a diamond. That seems like it's giving the wrong message. Hey there, Aavak. Hey, Robin. Here you go. Thanks, this is really nice. You're welcome. I need to purchase some stuff. I would like... lots of things. I don't know. No, I just want, mostly just want the stone. Lots of the stone. Thank you. Probably good enough. Ah! Balls! Why do I keep doing that? Why is it on left click? Why? And why does it sell the whole stack? I just wanted to pick it up and put it over there, but no, I sell the whole stack. One left click. Really? Game? Robin, is this a trick? You tell me the true. Was that a scam? You're like, wow. I mean, what? Maybe. It's okay. Since it's you, I forgive you. You're still a scallywag, though. And if I accidentally gave my item I just bought back to the cashier, I wouldn't expect them to be like, oh, well, you want to sell it back to me? Sure, here you go. Like a fraction of the price that you just paid. I'd expect them to be like, oh, yeah, you want me to hold this for you for a moment? Right, you're just putting your money back in your wallet. That's fine. You can have your thing back that you just bought. Here you go, Linus. How you doing? Warm rain is a pleasant way to get clean. Not so sure about that one, dude. At any rate, let's head home via the fast route. More stuff that I can buy. I don't know, Akasha. Today's been a bit of a lousy day for me. I'm soaking wet. Well, not that I actually mind that bit, though. I can't imagine the riding around in these heavy clothes is that particularly fun. I mean, usually when it's raining, warm or not, I actually tend to take less clothes outside with me. Because then, I don't have wet clothes. Wet clothes aren't fun. Wet me is fun. There we go. Let's see. I want to drop off... Do I really... you know what? I could just drop off this forage. Yeah, we'll drop off the forage there. Actually, no. Let's just sell it. There's no particular reason for me to hold on to it. And these can go as well. Alright, thank you. Let's get down to the industrial area. I've still got to harvest all of the hops yet. That's going to take a little while. I've got to gather a bunch of things from pretty much everywhere. It's fine, though. But I'm a busy chap today. I've got a jade. That needs to go to Penny. I've got a bunch of copper. Mm-hmm. I've got a bunch of this. Got a bunch of clay. Got some wood. Not a lot, mind you. But. And tis a big but, this one. I wouldn't mind getting more kegs. Like, I really would actually quite like having more kegs. So. How about we make that a reality? What do they require to make? Kegs. Oak resin. Ready on. I accept. There we are. I can make 4 kegs, apparently. Only I can't, because I can only make 2, because I've only got enough wood for 2. But I can easily chop down more. And that is what we're going to do. Then we're going to fill them with hops. Hops into these kegs. There we go. That's a small improvement. I do need a load more wood, though. The shears, you can go in here. Everything else is more or less okay. Yeah, let's go and just chop down a couple of trees. I actually really like the thunder and lightning in this game. That roll of thunder, that peal of thunder is just fantastic. I know some people really dislike lightning and thunder, but I actually adore it. It's remarkably soothing for me. Okay. I'm going to have to set up a new orchard around here, I'm imagining. This will be a little orchard, much like I've got up right next to the main house. Also, I definitely need to chow down not escargot. We will have some pepper poppers. Should have really eaten that earlier, honestly. And that gave me a fair old bit of food. We'll have one sashimi as well. Because working in the rain, I imagine, is harder than normal working. Because you're wet and your clothes all weigh more. It's basically a way of working out. I'm just increasing the difficulty level of my normal work. Yes, I could use a sword to get through all of those things. I'm just chronically lazy. Go. I desperately need to get more resin, though. That is one thing. Because the recipes for things have changed whilst I've been playing, I've been really bad at adapting to that. It's not that I don't understand it. It's just that I don't spend the time necessary to properly adapt to it. And it's entirely my fault. But it has caused issues. Right, we should have enough now, at least for another 2. So one... Oh, what do we lack? Ah. Aha! Iron bar, you almost thwarted me. But in the last moment, you realized the error of your ways. You decided to help me out. Thank you very much, Amber. Alright, the little lamps come on. That's actually very, very cheery. Let's see. We can drop off a lot of this. I'm just going to drop it off in there, though. One of these can go down, get some more hops. I really need to build this up massively compared to what I've currently got. And I know it hurts me as much as it hurts you. Basically, I'm causing myself pain. I'm atoning for some sort of sin. That's my excuse of why I endure this kind of horrible, messy inventory. I'm atoning for some great, great sin. What? Did lightning just strike something? Fairly certain it struck something really close by and ruined it. That means all of my lightning rods have been discharged. Or rather, they're currently charged, so that's actually a problem. Because they, you know, genuinely do protect my farm from things. And not just for getting batteries. Part of the whole thing of having the lightning rods is so that my farm doesn't get broken. Yeah, everything else is sorted. We'll leave that for another day, though. Down here. Is everything else right? More or less. Let's grab my watering can so I can harvest stuff. Grab these peppers while we're there. Thank you. Very good. And there was nothing to gather up there. No. Okay, well, we're just going to gather the hops, and then I'm going to make my way to the bathhouse. I don't know. I'm still of two minds, honestly. I feel, in a way, I feel that the penny situation is more or less designed to appeal to certain people, but for me, it just makes me feel wretched. Like I'm taking advantage. Like she's just some abused puppy, just looking for someone to be nice to her. And that feels like it's giving someone way too much control. It's one of those things where you, in a normal sort of relationship, it's give and take. But someone who's that desperate for someone who's kind to them would just give. And give and give and give. And as much as you might want to be a nice person, there's a point where you might not even realize you're taking too much. And that is honestly the biggest thing that works against Penny. And it is that sort of fear of being a bad person to her. And yes, I'm going to address this one now, actually. A couple of people have been like, wow, you're just gushing over these NPCs. Yes, I realize they're pixels. Of course I do. That doesn't mean that I can't empathize with the situation. It's called role-playing, or just empathy, actually. I used the right word the first time. Now, let me pop that up there. Right, okay. Now, we should be good to go. I'm going to make a run for it. It is 10 p.m. We have no time to do anything else. We've got to get to this bathhouse. One of the things that I often do with my Let's Plays is I try to add a lot of character to ones that don't have it, but when there's already quite a lot of character there, I'll just react to it, and I'll try and keep the reactions honest. I'm not just gaming the game, as it were. If something's mean, even if it's the most efficient and obvious game choice, I won't do it because it's mean. It's not actually me being mean. It's just me being human, really. Okay. Oh, this is a lovely setting, at the very least. This end of the pool I hardly ever come down to. There you are. I was worried you didn't get my note. Oh, don't say it like that, Penny, because it's been days. Don't say it like that, because then I feel like you've just been coming to the bathhouse every night, waiting. Also, how can you talk? Your mouth is clearly under the water. Looks like we're alone. Yes. I have been alone in here every other time I've come here as well. Water feels so good after being out in the cold of night, doesn't it? Yeah, actually, because it's raining out there. This is especially good times. Do you know why I asked you here tonight? You wanted to see me in my bathing suit. I'm sure that might be part of it. However, no, actually, I think Penny's purer than that. I'm not exactly sure, or no, I think you have something to tell me. I'm gonna go with this one because I feel that being too confident here might almost be make her feel even less comfortable. Really? I thought you'd have noticed by now. Okay, well, maybe I should have gone with the other one. How do I say this? I've been meaning to tell you for a while now about how I feel. For a moment, when she just stepped closer, I just thought it was like, okay, you're gonna tell me with your hands. Fair enough, I wasn't aware that you were that kind of person. There's the confidence in you that I hadn't appreciated before. Can't stop thinking about you. I've never felt this way about anyone. I really wish I could select the dot dot dot, but sorry, but I don't like you that way. See, someone actually clued me into this, and although it was a little bit of a spoiler, I did kind of appreciate them mentioning it, in that they said they didn't like this cutscene because it was binary. There was no middle ground, there was no grey area, there was no shades of affection. It was just, I either like you as much as you like me, or I flat out don't like you. It's more or less a binary decision, and emotions aren't binary things. I like Penny, the character of Penny. I really, especially in the beginning, I found her very charming. I think I've explained it probably as best as it's going to be explained. I'm worried about the potential for someone like that to be abused by someone who shows them any level of kindness, but I feel the same way about you. I thought you did, but I wasn't sure. Well, I'll always remember this night. Aww, that's actually sweet. And yet, there's just heaviness in my heart right now. The road to hell is paved with good intentions, as the saying goes. Or hugs and kisses, as Stardew Valley is effectively trying to teach me. Ah, Stardew Valley. Okay, well, we're back out in the freezing cold rain, almost as if fate is trying to tell us something. But we need to be a bed. It has been a very, very long and honestly emotionally tiring night, damn it. My bloody farm is being torn apart by lightning. I disapprove. Alright, poppy honey, mayonnaise, duck mayonnaise, cheese, more cheese, cranberry jelly, hot peppers, and more mayonnaise. Okay, fairly mayonnaise full day today. Alright, let's see how much we get from that from Lewis. But it is time for us to go curl up. Where is my dog? Oh, Snufkin, I really needed you tonight, Snufkin. I needed some moral support of some sort. Damn it. Ah. 1 out of 10. Would not dog again. Okay, well, we didn't make too small of an amount, though. It's slight compared to the whopping paydays we've been getting through most of summer. But still, our poppy honey did very well for us, and the gold star cheese very, very well. So yeah, not too bad, all things told. And on the morrow, we have a quest. We must go and deliver a jade to Penny. But that is going to be it for this episode. Leave a comment down below if you have any feedback or if you want to discuss that cutscene. But until next time, and as always, do take care.